Hello, everybody. I am Kate here with Dark Horse Comics, and today I'm joined by Roy Okupe from Unique Studios. Roy, can you give us a little overview on who you are and what Unique is?
Yes, first of all, I just want to say I'm so excited to be doing this. Always been a big fan of libraries and bookstores. So to me, I try to support as many in my community. But being able to now have my books hopefully being put into libraries is a great achievement, I would say, on my part. But yeah, I'm getting ahead of myself a little bit. My name is Roy Okupe. I was born and raised in Lagos, Nigeria. I grew up loving superheroes, comics, and fantasies, and I've always wanted to create these type of stories, but from an African perspective. Specifically, most of the inspiration I get is from Nigeria, but broadly West Africa as well. And yeah, for me, I've been, in the comics business, I would say, for about 5 6 years now. But honestly, I feel like this is the most exciting time, being able to partner with Dark Horse to bring my books to a wider audience and work with such a great company. For me, one of the things I'm most proud about is being able to have a creative team, that I would say is majority of Africans on the continent that actually work on the books, and obviously myself with the writing, and also some of the creative direction as well on the books is it's for me, that's really where it matters, is being able to bring other people into the fold, and get their creativity added to these books, and for things to be as authentic as they should be, but also for a global audience. And I think we've achieved that with all these titles.
You definitely do. I think, Unique is one of the most, not to, put a pun on it, is one of the most unique things that Dark Horse has coming up. And I'm really excited that we get a partner with you on this project, and see it kind of grow in size. You already have an audience from Kickstarter, of course, but as we bring it to Dark Horse, we're bringing it a little bit more into the fold of traditional publishing. And
Exactly.
I'm really glad that we get to be a huge part of that. So you kind of mentioned that you're trying to bring the stories of Africa to sort of global comics, but kind of
Yes.
what does that look like for you in the projects that you're bringing to life?
Yeah, I mean, I think, everything that I do always has its ties back to, either African history, culture, and mythology. If you look at one of our most popular titles, Malaika Warrior Queen, it's a historical fantasy story that takes place in a 15th century West Africa. You get to see what Africa looked like in the medieval times, how rulers ruled, how the kingdoms were, like it's the costumes, the outfits, the mannerisms, and things like that. So all that, honestly, like I'm very proud of that. But at the end of the day, I like to write very character-driven stories. So that's to me what makes people actually attach to these type of stories is, people relating with these characters and what they do and what they don't do and seeing themselves in there. So for me, as much as I'm proud of the mythology and the history and the culture that I bring to the table with these stories, I always say that I'm doing it for a global audience. And then you look at another title like EXO, The Legend of Wally Williams, which is more of a Afrofuturist sci-fi superhero epic story that takes place in a near futuristic Lagos, Nigeria, where I was born and raised. And at the core of that story, it's the relationship between a father and a son, and how responsibilities are usually passed on, and how, even we as human beings, sometimes we want to sort of carve our own path, but then we're living in the shadow of our parents. Like I said, these again, very, very human stories. And one of the titles that I'm most excited about, actually, and I'm sure I'm not supposed to be picking favorites, but Iyanu, Child of Wonder, is just something that's really near and dear to my heart. This is really deep in West African mythology, specifically the Yoruba culture, which is my culture from Nigeria. But you also get to see a teenage female, black protagonist, taking a lead role and being just awesome at it. And to me, that's something we don't get to see enough of. But like I said, these stories are all global. They're not just made for one particular type of person, as well. And again, that's what makes me really proud to bring these books to the public, is that I like to I like to akin it to something like, you know, when you're able to watch something like Avatar: The Last Airbender as a family, the kids can watch it, the adults can watch them, you know, it's accessible, you know, to a family. And that's how I write my books. I want it to be something that doesn't necessarily exclude a lot of people, but includes as many people as possible, but also tells real life stories. And then you have the African history, culture, and mythology, sort of like the icing on the cake, you know, as well. I think we've been able to do that successfully up until this point. And with the Dark Horse partnership, I think we're just going to hit it out of the park. And I really urge everyone, whether it's librarians or bookstores, to really take a look at this, because I feel like we need more of these, you know, just for kids, you know, in schools and in libraries. But I think just in general, the industry needs to see, you know, this material. We talk about diversity all the time. One thing that I feel like we sometimes overlook is authenticity. Anybody can just, you know, throw in diverse stories and put diverse characters. But how authentic is that to that culture? And now you have a situation like with Unique Studios, where you actually have African creators working on African books featuring African heroes in African history, culture, and mythology. And I feel like it doesn't get better than that.
I 100% agree. Something that I've seen a lot of conversation kind of coming up right now is there's a lot of, as people are looking for more Black stories, there's also the conversation of whether or not there's stories being told about like Black joy and right. depth and all this yeah. stuff. And I 100% yeah. believe that Unique brings so much of that, because yeah. they are joyful, they're fun. And like you said, they're yeah. character driven. So you see them yeah. struggle, but you also see them triumph, and you see them yeah. grow, and you see them change.
Yeah.
And the comparison to Avatar too yeah. is perfect as well, because there are people who, you know, grew up with Avatar who still mm-hmm. absolutely love it. And exactly. there are jokes in there that are for people who are older, for parents, yeah. for teens. Exactly. And yeah. there's a lot of that in Unique too, where like, well, some projects may skew a little bit younger. All of them yeah. are available to absolutely everybody. You know, yeah. there are pieces in there that you might pick up on as you yeah. get older. And there are pieces in there that, you know, kids are going to find really funny and really delightful.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, as we close up, I want to bring sort of our book on sale dates to everyone's attention. Like a Warrior Queen will be our first Unique book, and it comes out September 8th, 2021. It's hard to believe that that is already coming up.
Yes,
Yanu, Child of Wonder follows pretty closely, coming out September 22nd, 2021. And EXO, The Legend of Whale Williams arrives in October. So definitely check those out. Definitely keep in touch with anyone on the Dark Horse end. Those will be available, and we will continue to be promoting. Roy, anything else that you would like to add for our librarians today?
No, just that, you know, I wanted to also say that we really appreciate what you do. You guys are a very, very, very fundamental and also core part of what of society, you know, especially the ones that work with kids. Especially, people of color, children of color as well. I just want to say thank you to you guys, because a lot of you out there are actually actively looking for more books like these, to just not show one particular audience, but bring it to a broad audience of kids and adults. And I want to say that I'm just really grateful for that, because of you, creators like me get a chance to come on platforms like these and talk about the books that we have to share. I know a lot of you have been asking for more of these, so here you go. So hopefully we can get your support on these as well. Thank you.
Great. Awesome. All right. Well, enjoy the rest of your convention, everybody.